take care, okay?
You too.
To go inside. This might be my only chance of ever seeing the only man that I've ever loved. Please just let me in.
Oh, sorry, we can't do that. We hear that story out here a lot.
You have to believe me. Please let me in.
Sorry.
Passengers of International Airways Flight CX-109, please board the aircraft now through gate number 5. Thank you.
Adrian!
Madam,
Adrian!
Hold it! We cannot let you in,
Doctor. I'll call the police. You can't go in. I said
I really
we can't
need
let
to
you
talk
in.
To him, sir. You don't understand. I really have to.
All the remaining passengers of flight CX-109, please board the aircraft through gate number 5. All aboard, please.
You have
I really
to leave
have
now.
To talk to him now, sir. Please let me in. I really need to tell him
Karima,
something.
Call the police.
My son. Your father got his eyesight back. The world has never been on our side, Adrian. Why does everything have to be against us?
can't seem to forget you, Jennifer. My heart keeps telling me that you're still alive.
How long should I wait for another chance to see you again?
Happy birthday to you!
Make a wish!
Blow.
Yay! And it breaks my heart that he's not growing up with his real father.
Jeremy!
Still, Benicio is a good man.
Yes, he's growing.
And sometimes, I could hardly recognize myself. If you could only see me now.
Hi!
I hope you'd be proud of the person that I've become.
Oh, it's your mother.
Mother!
Oh.
I hope you're happy wherever you are. I will take good care of our son just for you. I'm going to shower him with all the love that I have, that I only used to give to you.
I'm doing my best to have a wonderful life, Jennifer. Because I know this is what you wanted for me. I'm making our dreams come true. But as the days and months pass me by, I realize that I just can't hold on to your memory forever. And Nicole, she's waited so long for me to come home. I hope that you can be happy for me. I love you. But I hope you won't get mad at me if I open my heart and start loving someone else.
And beautiful.
Nicole, take them outside first. It's
okay,
dusty
Father.
Here.
Come on, Madam Gina. Let's
I'll
go
just
outside.
Stay here first. Let's go.
Such a big garden, so refreshing. But I still don't understand. Should you get married first before living together under one roof?
But it's not just going to be the two of us here. You'll live here too, so come on. Come on, I want to show you this.
Oh.
Let's go.
Walk this way to show your presentation. As you can see, our features are composed of and this is your sword. Oh. I love you, baby.
You like my cookie?
It's good.
What should we do with that?
We're working on that, sir.
We should take care of those.
Dahil ikaw ang nasa isip ko. Dahil ikaw ang nasa isip ko. Ikaw ang kaibigan ko. Ikaw.
Oh, I dropped it.
Kaibigan ko, yan ang pangako ko. Yan ang pangako ko.
Para lang sa'yo.
Para lang sa'yo.
Yay!
Go to
Okay. Come on.
Oh, no.
Let's go. Where are you, Abby?
Come on, hurry.
Hold it, son. We're not late. I'm my trip.
Mother, come on. Why did you even have to talk to my handsome teacher? We're late because of you.
Wait. Hey, what's that about a handsome teacher, huh?
Oh, you stop it. It's nothing. Don't listen to what the kid says. What is it? What?
No wonder you were late for 2 hours. You dressed up for this.
And so? What's wrong with that?
Nothing.
The reason I wanted to look pretty is because I know just how much you two boys love me. And besides, I don't want people to think that I'm Jeremy's nanny.
Mm-hmm. Tell you what. I have a solution to that. You know what I'll do? I will put my arms around you so they won't think you're a nanny. And after that, I'll even add a kiss.
Oh, stop. Stop.
Ooh, that. They're so sweet to each other.
Yes, now come
okay,
on.
Okay, that's
you
enough.
Late.
We're late.
Nicholas?
Come on, love your cake. Adrian.
Hi.
You're really something else. You were able to gain Dalnus's trust right away.
You know, it wasn't easy at first, but of course, you know how fathers can be. They find it really hard to trust other men, especially when they have a daughter. And she's the only daughter.
That's true. And besides, hello, why wouldn't my father grow to like Adrian? Adrian has been doing such a good job running the sugar mill all by himself. If you remember, all of our businesses have already folded up. The mill is the only one left. And we were about to close around 2 years ago, but then Adrian came, and now we're doing great.
Well, you know how high her expectations can be.
What?
And when I'm at work, she's my boss. And when I get home, she's still my boss. And every day she keeps complaining.
Complaining? I hardly ever complain.
I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding.
And you can't stand
I'm sorry.
Now.
You know it.
I was joking.
Hey, Jeremy. Well,
getting nervous, little man?
I don't want to embarrass Mother. She even dressed up for this.
Hey, she's always beautiful, even without makeup. Look at her, Jeremy. Come on, look at your mother. There's your mother. She's pretty. So, are you still nervous?
Mm-hmm.
Solution for that. Here.
How can this be magic? This is just a coin.
Shh.
That's no ordinary coin. That was given to me by an old lady from far away. And she said that it came from a volcano. A volcano in her town. She even said that warriors used to live there. And that's where they died. So you have to promise me that you won't tell your mother.
That it has magic?
Yes, it is magic. Are you still scared?
Not anymore.
Now that's my boy. Warriors don't get scared. You're a warrior now. Okay?
Okay.
You can do it right. Now where's my hug? Well, where's my hug? Give me a big hug. Go!
Yes!
Go, go.
Give us 5 more years and we'll be able to recover completely.
But hey, there are rumors. I heard that Don Jose is selling the sugar mill.
Just rumors. There will always be rumors, but you shouldn't believe in them.
And now, our next number will come from our first order, Jeremy Chuatojo.
Hey, this isn't a cockfighting ring. Hey,
so
just
what?
Relax, okay?
Thank you.
Hey, Nicole. So, Adrian hasn't proposed yet?
Oh, will you stop that, Charlize? At this day and age, do you really think that people still do that? Besides, marriage is just papers. And what will be the assurance that that person will stay with you forever? And besides, you already know that, after he came from abroad, we've been living together for 2 whole years. What more can I ask for?
You have a point. I really admire you, Nicole. Are you enjoying yourself?
Well... Oh, wait a minute.
Okay, no
Excuse
problem.
Me. Hi.
Madam, happy birthday.
Oh, thank you.
I hope you didn't mind. I just came in. I had to do so many things, so I stayed late at the sugar mill.
Oh, that's okay. I don't mind. Have you seen Adrian? He seems to have disappeared.
Oh, yes. I ran into him outside. He's going to check the plantation.
The plantation?
Yes.
Surprise.
Oh, Adrian, you and your little surprises.
Be careful. Happy birthday. Oh, this is not the only surprise I have for you. This is for you. Open it.
Okay. A pen? You're giving me a pen? That's really sweet. You're so sweet. Pen. You know, you really wasted the whole setup. You got me a pen. You're giving me a pen! Goodness.
So you can sign the marriage contract. Miss Nicole Fontabella, can you officially be my wife? Well, aren't you going to say something? A simple yes will do.
Adrian. Adrian, you know that I don't need a ring or a wedding. I'm fine with what we have. I'm already happy. And you keep on telling me that I was the one who helped you start a new life. But the truth is, you were the one who helped me get to know myself better. You helped me fulfill my dreams. What more can I ask for? I already feel complete when you're around. I'm happy with you. And now you're asking me to marry you? Of course I will. With all my heart.
Thank you.
Go!
Whoa, look at him.
Hey there, Roderick!
Hey, Jeremy!
He's acting like a grown-up.
Look at that! Look at him! See what you just did to him!
Look at that! It's that coin necklace that you gave him. He won't let it go. Why couldn't you have given him a cleaner and better-looking coin to wear?
Look at that! That coin is probably the dirtiest coin in the world. Please, can you talk to him tomorrow? Take back what you said about the magic so he can take it off his neck.
Yes, madam. Now, what do you think? Do you really want to date that handsome teacher?
Hey, stop it. That man was just a friend. I have this feeling that you're jealous of him.
What? Me? Jealous?
Mm-hmm.
Should I be?
I don't know.
I already know that you're madly in love with me.
Wow.
But tomorrow, you will fall in love with me even more. We're going to see the farm.
The farm? But Benicio, I already told you that I won't be going to the farm with you and Jeremy. I have a meeting with Mr. Lee today.
But Michelle's the manager. Why don't you tell her to go instead?
But Mr. Lee is my client.
Mm-hmm.
Why would you let Michelle take him from me?
Mm.
And besides, if I finally get this account from Mr. Lee, I'll add 400 million to your bank's revenue.
Is that so?
But I'm not going to put it in your account.
What?
I will put it in your account on one condition.
Oh, no. Here we go again. Okay, let's hear it.
If I end up getting the Mr. Lee account, you are going to make me manager so that I can finally earn enough to pay you off.
But I've wanted to make you manager for the longest time.
I didn't want it then because I still haven't proven myself. At least once I get to close that account with Mr. Lee, then nobody can say that I didn't deserve the promotion.
Okay, then. You do what you have to do, and Jeremy and I will just wait for you. You're coming with us to see the farm. Period.
Ben.
Period. Okay? Good luck.
And for all the employees in the department store, we can all give them individual ATM accounts.
Well, the other bank is already doing that for me.
And if you want to make pickup deposits every day, I can send an armored van.
But isn't that too much?
That's how much we value your business, sir. Sue?
Thank you.
It's Sir Benicio!
Hey, Marisa. Mother will get mad at you if she finds out.
You don't have to follow me everywhere, you know. Sir Benicio! Sir Benicio! Russell, hurry! Hurry! Ouch!
Now look at that. If I didn't follow you, who will help you when you fall down? Let me see that. What the... That's what you get for following Benicio around.
Will you stop getting in the way of my dreams? It doesn't hurt anyway. Let's go. Come on.
Good afternoon, madam.
Get our things from the trunk.
Yes, sir.
Yay!
Hey, not so fast. Hey.
Mr. Chuitoka, will you wait for me? What it looks like you...
What?
You will have to promote me.
What?
You have to promote
what?
Me.
Mm-hmm.
You have to promote me.
Not just yet.
Let's go and play.
What?
Mm-hmm.
But you promised.
Because I already have bigger
Yay.
Plans for you. Huh? Come on, let's go. We have plans for other. We have plans for other.
So when's the wedding?
Oh, stop it, Father. The man just proposed to me. We still haven't talked about the details.
Oh, Adrian. Tatum will be your best man.
Of course, but will you please tell Tatum that now that he's already graduated, he should come here and visit us and spend his vacation here.
Don't worry, I'll tell him.
You know, you really have to be stricter with him.
No, he's okay.
Father, you should have been down here last night. You know what Adrian did last night? He finally got the family of the Magundayaos to sign on with us. They're already registering.
Mm-hmm.
See, I told you, Father, you don't need to do all the work by yourself. Adrian will take care of everything, won't you?
Well, my only concern right now is that rumor that the other sugar mill is spreading about us, that you're selling them our sugar mill.
Mm-hmm.
But I told him that's impossible. More food?
No, I'm full now. Father, are you okay? Father, how are you feeling? Belen? Belen?
Drink this, Adam? Here. Drink this.
Get his medicine.
Yes.
You already know where it is, right? Oh, there. Are you okay?
Oh, yes. I'm okay.
Belen's getting your medicine. Are you all right?
Run after it. Come on.
Okay.
There, good.
Go, Jeremy. Yes.
There.
Be careful.
That's right. Do
okay.
it like this.
Oh, like this?
Go try it. Like
it's
that.
Over.
There.
Yeah.
Now what?
Here,
look
here,
at that.
Give it to me.
I can't believe we
How
ran
you,
here
Catherine?
Just so you
here,
could
here,
check
here.
Out Benicio. Stop dreaming about it.
Why should I? There's nothing wrong with having dreams. You just have to make them come true. You'll see. Someday I'm going to be as rich and smart as Sir Benicio. I'm going to leave this province. And I will go live in the city. Over there, they have nice paved roads. I won't slip and fall there.
Not like that. Do it like this. Come here, I'll teach you.
Okay.
There. Oh, no, not like that, no. Come here, come here. Your mother will teach you.
Yes, I there. Will. Over here, come here.
Like this?
Father, the doctor said that you shouldn't move around too much. You should relax more. And don't you forget to take your medicine. Okay?
Madam, there's someone outside looking for Don Jose.
Oh, who is it?
Father, don't move. I'll go see who it is. You stay and rest.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening. Benicio Chotoko.
Nicole Fuentebella.
Adrian Toazen.
Adrian.
Mr. Chotoko, you're one of the most influential sugar barons here in our province.
Yes. We've never met in person. I called the sugar mill today, and I was able to talk to the secretary. Don Jose's condition just got worse?
Oh, yes. We think he almost had a heart attack, but he's okay now. Thank you very much for checking on him.
Actually, I came here for business.
How touching.
Oh, sorry if I offended you. I'm actually very frank, and Don Jose knows that, and I know he respects me for it. He's actually selling the sugar mill to me, and I thought we could sign the
papers.
I'm
sorry? What did you say?
You mean Don Jose hasn't told you? He still has a lot of papers to check and sign. I was afraid that he would. I just wanted to make sure.
You can leave now, Mr. Chotoko.
Nicole.
Miss Fuentebella, the deal is between Don Jose and I. Apparently, you're not involved.
I want you out of here.
Nicole.
Please give him these papers.
I'm his daughter. I'm highly involved in running the sugar mill. And we are not selling it.
Mr. Chuotoko, I think you should leave now. This is not a proper time.
Or at least in the morning.
Thank you. Whatever happened to your meeting that made you smoke again? That cigarette can never listen to your problems, and it won't give you any good advice, but you're lucky I can do both. So now go. What is it?
There's a big transaction that I'm involved with.
Mm-hmm.
Someone's selling me a sugar mill. And just when I decided to go and buy it, that's when the daughter came into the picture.
Oh, it's the daughter. Is she young? Mm-hmm. She will sell. She's going to change her mind. Maybe tomorrow or the next day she'll call you.
There you go with your instincts again.
Hey, you forget my bets at cockfights were always right on the money. I have a good eye for people. Want to bet on it? Good catch.
You've sold all of our businesses, the flower shop, shipping line, and now even the sugar mill.
I was going to let you know about this, but it's just that.
Let us know? But when? And don't you dare tell me that Adrian and I can't do anything about it because you own the sugar mill. Because whether you like it or not, we poured our blood and sweat into that sugar mill just so it can get back on its feet again. Father, that sugar mill is all you have left.
Yes, Mr. De Jesus. Please have all our financial statements ready. And then, can we talk to someone from the bank?
I have already thought this deal through. And if I don't do this now, the bank will foreclose the mill and all your efforts will go to waste.
But why didn't you tell us about all of this sooner? I have been asking you for the longest time to let me sit on that board, but you never let me.
Nicole.
Is it because you still don't treat me as part of your family? Is it because you still see Adrian and I as your employees?
Nicole, I have made my decision.
You made us look like fools.
I'll be going as well.
Mother.
Good morning, my son.
Good morning, wow. Mother.
Good morning.
Good morning, Uncle Benicio.
Come here. Over here.
Uncle Benicio.
Yes.
Let's go to the river tomorrow.
Mm.
I want to show you how good I am at swimming.
Oh, really?
Yes, because you taught me how to swim.
You really know
Besides,
how to flatter
Besides, I'm
me.
A big boy now.
Okay, that's enough. Come and eat first before you go planning the rest of your day.
You overwhelm me with all your questions, huh?
Come here. You have to eat it all.
Hello. Donazan.
Send me all the papers that I need to sign.
I went to your house last night. It seems we have a problem with your daughter.
It's my decision, not hers.
Well, if that's the case, then we won't have a problem. I just want to make sure...
I assure you, it's not going to be a problem.
Fine then. Okay.
Everything's all right?
You better be ready for this, okay? This is the big plan that I was telling you about. You'll be managing the sugar mill.
What? Benicio, ever since I graduated, my work revolved around the bank. I know my way around the bank now, but not the sugar mill. I don't know anything about it.
But you'll learn. It won't take you too long to learn the ropes.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning to you, too.
I know that I'm good at what I do, Mr. Chuotoko. If I wasn't, I don't think I would ever earn my position and your respect. But what's going to happen to my job at the bank? If I take this job, I will have so many things to turn over.
Hold on. Does this mean you're accepting this job offer? You're already talking about turnovers.
I have to think about it, Mr. Chuotoko.
Come here, I just want to show you something.
Hey, is there?
What is it?
Cut me something to eat over there.
Honey, what are you doing?
I'm leaving. If they don't want my help, then I'm not going to force myself to work here.
Honey, I understand. This is only your initial reaction. But you should not lose hope.
My father's decision is final.
Look, I asked someone I know to look at just how much the sugar mill owes in debt. The truth is, it's for foreclosure. But we can still stay here and negotiate.
With the bank?
With Mr. Chwatoko.
So does this mean that you're also thinking of selling the sugar mill? Is that it, Adrian?
Okay, go and cut all that well. There's more where that came from. Oh.
This is huge.
What is it? Look, did you get into a fight?
Okay.
Tell me and I'll punch them in the face.
I can see that.
Do you see that woman?
Pretty big place.
That girl with Sir Benicio?
Hmm. You got someone in your hair.
Oh.
What is it?
That's Madame Catherine.
There you go.
According to Kevin, that's the wife of Sir Benicio's late brother, his sister-in-law.
Wow. You sure know a lot about them. Well, whoever she is, I still don't like her. Just look at her. Look at that.
No, that's the way.
Look at how close she is to Sir Benicio. I really think she wants to get married to Sir Benicio.
Why don't you just admit that you want Sir Benicio to be with our mother? Now, will you concentrate on your job? You're wasting your time.
Mm-hmm.
Come on. I'll show you the other side.
Okay. Hi, Russell.
Hi, Bebang.
You know, I think what I'm going to do is so much better than just wasting my time by flirting with some ugly girl. You know, I'm going to tell my mother on you.
Oh, really? Huh? Suit yourself, then.
Will you do your job?
We don't have any other choice, Nicole.
80-20?
I have reviewed everything. This is the best possible proposition that we can offer him.
What if they won't go for it? I mean Father and Mr. Chwatoko.
Well, at least we can say we tried.
I really don't know what I would do if I didn't have you with me, Adrian.
You already know that I will always be here for you, right?
I hope you don't mind. Benicio told me that I can ask you to teach me the ropes about this place. The only thing I know is that sugarcane eventually becomes sugar.
Are you going to be the new manager assigned by Benicio? Oh, I mean Sir Benicio here in the farm?
Oh, no, not me. Benicio will stay here. He's assigning me to the sugar mill.
Oh, but I don't know anything about running a sugar mill.
Oh, no, that's okay. I just want to know and understand everything that happens around here. I just want to be familiar with it.
Caught a lot of fish. Hey, look, that's Mother. And she's with Madame Catherine now.
Please?
All right.
Thank you. The princess heard the old man's call. However, she did not know that Aladdin's old lamp had magical powers. She happened to exchange Aladdin's old lamp for a new one.
Oh. Hey.
Father.
How are you? Huh? Oh. Here are the papers of the sugar mill that you will need.
I haven't accepted your offer. I told you, I have to study it first, remember?
Come on,
ouch.
Just say yes.
Ouch.
Hello, Mr. Chotoko.
This is Mr. Adrian Tuazon, assistant manager of the sugar mill.
Oh, I was thinking of setting up a meeting with you.
Madam, here you go.
Thank you very much. Adrian Tuazon?
How are you? Oh, by the way, tomorrow you have a meeting at the sugar mill. They want to discuss something, and you'll be meeting with their resident manager, Mr. Tuazon. Adrian Tuazon.
What about you?
Why would I bother meeting up with them when I'm meeting with Don Jose himself?
It can't be. Jennifer Limbaga. You're really stupid. It can't be. It's just his namesake. They just have the same name. That's just it. Don't be crazy. No. No. They just have the same name. It's not him.
Catherine Chotoko. Who is she? Has she been here at the sugar mill before?
No, she hasn't. But aren't you going to have a meeting with Benicio later?
No, he told me that this Catherine Chotoko will be managing the mill. That's why he arranged a meeting with her tomorrow. You know, we have to find out what that woman wants. We have to impress her and even woo her to get what we want.
Sir Adrian.
Yes. Jason, just call me Adrian.
Once you've sold the sugar mill to Benicio, are you leaving us? Are you and Nicole going to leave? We actually had a meeting about all of this. That we will have to adjust again to new management if you leave the sugar mill.
Don't you worry. We are not leaving. I'm willing to promise you that. That's why you have to help me with this woman, okay?
All right.
It can't be. That man can't be Adrian. It's just someone with the same name. It can't be Adrian.
Mother, stop moving around. I can't sleep when you do that.
Sorry, Jeremy, sorry. Okay, I'll stop.
Stop moving already.
Yes, I'll stop moving. Sorry. I'm sorry, son. Let's go to sleep. Come on.
Sir, we don't have to sell the whole mill. Just do this at least for Nicole. And I hope that you can still trust me with this.
Okay. Let's try it out. I'm doing this because I trust you as my son.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Where's Jeremy?
He's waiting for you in the car.
Benicio? Benicio, please wait! Benicio, don't leave yet! Benicio! Benicio!
Yes?
Will you hold on, please?
I'm taking Jeremy out.
But please wait! What about the meeting at the sugar mill?
You can handle it.
Come on,
let's go. You can do it.
Goodbye, Mother.